beautiful South Florida. There's a look at Hard Rock Stadium in Miami. The scene a few moments ago, here it is. It's unlike any other in sport. As both teams made their way out of the tunnel, these folks are fired up as their guys are ready to do battle between the Tampa Bay Buccaneers and the Miami Dolphins. Charles Davis. Charles, you look at the Dolphins as they enter play in this one. It's been a great start to the season. Back-to-back wins to begin the campaign.
Yeah, you don't want to get too excited. There's still a lot of season to go, but they've come out playing good fundamental football, and that might carry them a long way.
On the other side of the field for the visiting Bucs, they come in at an early crossroads here, facing a tough opponent on the road where a loss would make them 0-3.
And when you start that way, doubts really start to creep into a locker room, and guys start to battle each other instead of worrying about winning games.
So here come the Dolphins now as they get set to take over on offense. They will be led out by the 6-foot lefty from Alabama. It's Tua Tagovailoa.
Well, he did go 2-2 in the last ball game. Well, actually, he went 2-2-1, with the one being the victory.
Yeah.
That's the bottom line there. But wasn't it funny at practice? He threw one when we were watching, threw an interception, and the defense got on him a little bit good-naturedly. But they're letting him know, you got to cut down those interceptions. We can't bail you out all the time.
Yeah, 2 touchdowns, 2 picks. But as you said, they got the win in that effort last week. And he's got this to the 30 before being taken down. The big gainer there on the catch and run, 37 yards. So the big play has him all the way down to the 30 now for first and 10. Looking to pass, Tua. This pass to Jennings, and he makes a catch. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. This duo locked in, 14 yards there, and a first down. So the, and this is caught by Parker for a Miami touchdown. Devontae Parker, his second touchdown on the season. And the Dolphins are going to take a first quarter lead. Well, these guys scored touchdown after touchdown in that win a week ago. So how do they come out this week? Same way. They've got that momentum going, a touchdown on the opening drive.
I think it's safe to say that they're in a groove, isn't it? I mean, a lot of times we've seen where teams have scored a ton of points the week before. The very next week, struggle to score almost as if they used it all up. Not in this case. This group appears locked in.
We're going to have to make some adjustments if you're on the other side of that football.
First try on offense for the Bucs and their veteran quarterback, Tom Brady.
And I'll bet he's talking to his guys about resisting the temptation to try and turn this into an up-and-down game, almost like basketball, where both teams press and one team gets an advantage. Our team's trying to run with them, and they're just not equipped for it. Doesn't matter whether you're equipped or not. Just settle in. Get calm before you go for the big strikes.
Brady and the Bucs now with a first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. He'll throw from the gun. Looking middle, and it's incomplete. Mike Evans, the one he was looking for. And it's second down.
A lot of times it's that first read that you had. Maybe you get it in pre-snap, and he locked in on his target. But he was covered quite well, and that one's incomplete.
An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. To throw again, Brady. And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on, third down. Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions.
Yards to go.
Working from the gun, it's Brady. This into the hands of his running back, Ronald Jones. And he's going to be stopped here a few yards short of the first as the tackle is made at the 33. Give him 8 on the play, and it'll be fourth down.
They've got good playmakers on the offensive side of the ball. I don't know what happened last week to really hurt their performance and hold down their production, but I would dare say that this week in practice, there's a lot of talk about how they're going to increase their proficiency.
Yeah, it was a good start getting the playmakers involved. You mentioned that to me pregame. That's what they did there.
Yeah, I think a lot of people think the coaching staff really gets on them, and that's how they motivate them. Most of these guys are self-motivated. They have a lot of pride in their performance.
And they'll come out with a 3 tight end look on the first play of the drive. Here's the first carry from Matt Breida. And a 6-yard gain gets him right around the 43.
Breida, the ball carrier.
A check on Breida's numbers from last week. Just downright unbelievable. I mean, when you amass that many yards, I don't know what else to say.
Personally, I thought it was a game for the ages for him.
Tagovailoa going to try and throw on third down. And Jennings has it. And he is going to have the Dolphins first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. The defense surrenders a 13-yard pass play there on third and one. He's got the first down here inside the 30. And he gets this one down to the 24. Back-to-back receptions for him, and it's another first down. Tua going to hand this one to Breida. And not much of a hole there as he gets it down to about the 24-yard line.
The tackle.
Shaquille Barrett in on the tackle.
A gain of a yard. Brings up
Tua. Wants to throw it on second down. That one complete to his receiver Jennings. And they've got it inside the 10 at the 8. Going to the air. Tagovailoa. He's now just 3 yards shy of 197 yards receiving on the contest and a first down. And he'll be brought down here at the 3 yard line. That'll bring up second and goal after the game. And that is caught. Touchdown, Miami. Gary Jennings, his first touchdown here of the new campaign. And the Dolphins are able to grow their lead. A nice throw there by the second year quarterback.
That's the kind of play he would have made as a rookie, because usually your rookie season is a continuation of your college days. A lot of one read, and if you don't have it, you just take off and go. Now he's settled in the pocket a little bit more, reading the field and getting to a second and sometimes third progression. That was a nice play.
And it's good, and they have jumped out here to a quick 14-0 first quarter lead.
14. Buccaneers, nothing. Jason Sanders to kick off for Miami.
Now after the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Sanders. From the 6. And able to get this out to the 25.
The over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
Tampa Bay, they're getting ready to set up shop here for their second drive. They've been outplayed early, no question. Down 14-0 already as they come up first and 10. Shotgun now for Brady. Almost able to intercept it. That's one he would have liked to have held on to on his first drive. Instead, second down.
It's now second.
An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. Here's Ronald Jones, first carry for the USC man. And this will be a gain of 5 as he gets it to the 30. 5 yards, now it's third and 5.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent gain.
And it's third down.
From the gun on third down, Brady looking for Godwin, but it's intercepted. Picked up by Jair Alexander. And he'll bring this one back to the 29.
Intercepted.
So more problems here in this first quarter. Already 2 scores down, and here they give away the football.
And if I'm the head coach, I think it's time to start lighting a fire under some of these guys. Now, you have to do it within your personality. They can't perceive it as fake. But I'd go get after some guys because they don't look ready to play to me. They look flat, uninspired. It's time to get moving.
They'll set up a screen for Breida. And on this one, he'll get to the 15, right at the 15-yard line. A gain of 5, good enough for the first down.
Gotta like what we're seeing from him so far in this game. This is the third game of the season. And he's already accumulated an AFC Offensive Player of the Week award in this young year.
Yeah, week 2. He's got it. Touchdown, Dolphins. Mike Gesicki there to make the grab. And the Dolphins are able to extend that advantage. Boy, these guys are off to the races, Charles. 20-0 already, extra point pending.
Yeah, you always hear that term. They just boat race someone. Heck, his car race, motorcycle race, plane race, whatever you want. Right now, they are sprinting past him.
It's good, and before you know it, it's 21-0. The drive there only spanning 3 plays, and it ends with a touchdown for the Dolphins.
Jason Sanders to kick off for Miami.
Now after the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Sanders. Taken in at the 3. And they'll get him down inside the 30 at the 27.
On the return, the Bucs take over first and 10 at their own 27.
Again, we see Tom Brady and the Bucs set to take over. And he'll look to rebound from the early interception that led to 6 points the other way.
And when he threw the interception and he had to come to the sideline, I guarantee his first thought wasn't about the interception itself, but what could result. And I know he was thinking to himself, come on, defense, bail me out. Well, they weren't able to in this situation. Now he's got to go out and atone for it himself, but he can't force things.
And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39. It's a first down on a gain of 10.
Well, these guys certainly need something good to go their way, because this first quarter has been something of a disaster for them trying to move the ball. But that completion there, maybe can get them focused and moving in the right direction.
First down, Tampa Bay.
The numbers for Evans a week ago, 4 catches, 76 yards.
That was a nice job there pulling that one in. Now, this is an offense that will certainly spread the ball around a bit, and this is a guy that defenses had better focus on.
From midfield, here's Brady. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete.
Brady's pass.
And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. Another nice gain, 13 yards that time, and another first down. Now a draw play. This is Jones. And not a lot of daylight, not really any daylight inside, as he's going to be stopped right at the line of scrimmage. Brings up second down. First carry now for Keyshawn Vaughn. And they're able to get this one past the 30 to the 25-yard line.
Tackled at the 25-yard line.
I have to admit, I'm excited by that play call and the end result, because this is a team that's down big early in the first quarter, and a lot of teams will just panic, abandon the playbook, and just start firing the ball all over the place. It's way too early for that. Stick to what works for you.
Down double digits, and we talked about their game plan being both running and passing there. You're right. They're sticking to the game plan, getting the ground game going.
A lot of football left to be played.
On second down, it's Vaughn. And he stopped immediately there. He got maybe a half yard at most, but officially they'll be left with a third and two.
No gain on the play. And it brings up third down.
They'll try and run for it with Vaughn. And he won't be close to a first down as he runs into a wall right around the line of scrimmage. No gain there on the play, and that's going to leave him with a fourth down. And he got off the end there very quickly to make that play.
Yeah, it was almost like the bullet train, wasn't it? I mean, just zoom, quick. And what a terrific play, holding them to no gain.
They'll run it with Jones. Not going anywhere. They stop him for no gain. Doug Marone can only shake his head. His guys are turned away, and the Dolphins defense is able to hold. Two and now on first down. Now they set up the screen. That's complete. And he's going to be brought down on what will be the final play of this first quarter. 21-0 our score after one.
Nothing.
That last catch short of the marker by just a yard leaves him with a very manageable second and one. Tagovailoa working out of the gun. And this one's incomplete. The intended receiver was Jakeem Grant. And it's third and short.
Incomplete. Brings up third down and
Tua sets up to pass it. They'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. And he's going to get to the 31. Enough for the first down.
That's good.
Able to get what they need to keep the drive going with a 6-yard pickup on third down. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. And again, it's Tagovailoa. And that'll be knocked away. It's incomplete. Devontae Parker, the intended receiver, but it'll be second down.
That's a nice job there, because you've got to play the ball, not the man, when in coverage. That'll keep you away from a lot of needless penalties. He's able to knock that one away.
And that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's third down. So back-to-back incompletions, and that has him staring at a third and 10. And it's caught by Parker. And he is going to have the Dolphins first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. On first down, here's Breida. And he's able to get across midfield and down into Buccaneer territory. 4. They run with Breida. And he'll be brought down at the 45-yard line. 4 yards the pickup, first down. Now it's Breida. Levante David in on the tackle. We should mention, to go along with a great game he had last week, he was rightfully named AFC Offensive Player of the Week.
And he shares that with his offensive line, the tight end, his fullback. He's looking for more and more of that in this game.
And he's going to go down. Back near midfield at the 49. So now after the sack, Tua and the Dolphins staring at a third and long.
Well, maybe that can give him a little bit of a pick-me-up, a little bit of a jolt. One of the few things has gone right defensively.
Because other than that, it's really been a first half to forget. That was no third and two. That was third and 16, but they get the conversion anyway. What a first half this has been offensively. I mean, defensively, what do you do when you're getting torched like this?
Now, these receivers are absolutely wearing them out. So two thoughts come to mind. One, get some oxygen. It can fill up your lungs a little bit. And number two, talk to your guys up front. You need a pass rush to help slow them down.
And he'll go down here at the 12-yard line. First down screen pass, good for 5. Now they go screen, it's complete. And he will take it in for a Dolphins touchdown. Matt Breida, his 9th touchdown of the season. And the Dolphins head on to their lead. There are several elements to a well-executed screen pass. This one resulted in a touchdown. It had all of those elements.
Yeah, you're so right, because you really need the rush to almost get to the quarterback, almost get to the passer. Then you've got to get the ball thrown perfectly, whether it's to the running back, the wide receiver, whoever the screen guy is. And, of course, the blocking has to form in front to get it downfield for the touchdown.
From the 10. And beyond the 20, but not by much. In fact, just a yard pass there to the 21.
22-yard line.
Here's the Tampa Bay offense and Ronald Jones leading him out. They've given him some touches. They haven't had a lot of success on the ground. Do you maybe keep going to that well, or do you mix it up more?
I think you mix it up more, try to loosen things up. Get the defense to react to other people, other plays, but don't forget about it. That's your horse. You know, Secretariat lost twice in his career.
So educational. That's very true, kids. Look it up. So it goes as a completed pass, but they lose a full 5 yards. So they had the big loss on that first down pass play and facing a second and long. Here's Brady. He sets up the screen to Jones. And he'll go down just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. They get 7 there on the screen. It'll set up a third down.
And it's third down.
From the gun, it's Brady. The Dolphins get there this time, and they bring him down.
Competition comes up in so many different ways. And right now, this unit, their competition is who's going to get to the quarterback the most times. I've got 5 sacks last week. We just saw their first one of this game.
Returnable for Grant. Great blocking, nearly sprung in there. 28-yard return. And the Dolphins will begin this drive in great field position, first and 10. Tua and the rest of the Dolphin offense heading back out. He's enjoying a great deal of success. His team is also enjoying a great deal of success.
Yeah, he's got that nice little, what I call the QB lean going right now. You see that little stroll that he's got
going?
Yeah, he's definitely got that. You see him throwing the football, the nice little video. He's seeing that in his head as well because he wants more of that to happen. So anytime you see him that relaxed, that comfortable, usually it's a big thumbs up for his team.
Yeah, it's been a big highlight day for him. He was looking for his tight end, Mike Gesicki. That'll bring up second down.
He certainly had a good game throwing the ball so far, but I think he was trying to take that from good to great with that throw, trying to get one downfield.
Tua to try again on second down. Oh, it's a screen pass. That's complete. And he'll be out of bounds about a half to a full yard shy of the 5. A good pickup there, 21 yards. And with that completion, he's now north of 200 yards here in the first half. Boy, a tough start for the secondary defensively.
It is, and it's got to put a dent in their confidence. And, you know, you always want to keep that up and feel like you can always bounce
officially, and now it'll be third. And he'll take this into the end zone for a Dolphins touchdown. Matt Breida, his 10th touchdown of the season, second of the game, as his guys continue to put this one out of reach.
Okay, we need to double check here with Marvin because he keeps all of our good stats, but what I've got is five drives, five touchdowns, and they've got a nice healthy lead.
After the first drive, we thought things might be clicking. They're really clicking at this point. They're clicking about as much as they can click. I just said click a lot.
Yes, you did, but that's okay because the guy who's coordinating the defense, trying to slow them down,
good luck.
He's going to have hair that looks like mine very soon. Not much of it.
And up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25.
First and 10 at their own 26-yard line.
And this offense trotting back onto the field. Let's turn our attention here to Ronald Jones. He's just been looking for some space. You know, I'm not going to pin it on him or the offensive line, but they need to get this run game going better.
Sometimes you just have to credit the defense. They came in with a plan themselves. So I think now you try and mix things up a little bit. Get the ball in the hands of some other people, find some other playmakers, but always let the defense believe that he's still a threat.
I was going to say, don't forget about it.
No, don't take him totally out of the game.
On second down, here's the option. And he'll bring it up here to right at the 40-yard line. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down.
A gain of six. First down, Tampa Bay.
Throwing now is Brady. Over the middle, and it's incomplete.
From the snap, he certainly looked like he knew where he wanted to go with the ball, but surprise, that guy was covered. So that took his attention elsewhere to no avail.
Looking back to the air on second down, it's Brady. That quick pass here to Godwin. And oh, he's going to be brought down by the face mask. Here come the flags. This is going to get him a first down. So they'll take the yardage and tack on 15 more for the face mask.
Talk about a play that absolutely costs you in the end. Just trying to do your job, right? Trying to get him on the ground. Next thing you know, they'll march up another 15 against your squad.
And this is caught off a deflection. And he's into the end zone for a Tampa Bay touchdown. Mike Evans, 36 yards, as they are now on the board here in the first half.
I'm not sure that they have illusions right now of, okay, we're going to score eight times in a row, we're going to be terrific. But to get one, that was huge for them. That has to feel much better right now.
And you do have, we're still in the first half, you do have the entire second half. There's something about that goose egg that just looked bad on that board, but now they've broken it.
Yeah, broken through. Can they maintain the pace? We'll see as we go along.
And a decent return out to the 27-yard line.
Take over first and 10 at their own 27-yard line.
Tua Tagovailoa in the offense heading back out. He's got to be feeling pretty good. Play him well. Team has the lead, so just looking to mount a drive here that ends in the end zone.
And all quarterbacks will tell you, hey, we love a running game, helps us out. But at the end of the day, they want to rely on their arm, throw the football, feel good about things, keep things moving in the right direction. Right now, that's exactly what we're seeing.
And we'll see if that continues. A solid run on first down. Gain of seven. Leaves him with a second and three. He's got the first down and more inside the 40. And they will get him down, but not before he gets very good yardage there. As that will lead us right into the two-minute warning. 23 yards the pickup there. So from Buccaneer territory now, it's first and 10 at the 30-yard line. Here's Tagovailoa to throw. Now they set up the screen. That's complete. And he'll take this into the end zone for a Dolphins touchdown. Matt Breida on his way to a monster game. Three first half touchdowns. And the Dolphins just continue to pour it on.
I know Paul Revere talked about by land or by sea, right? You know, one by land, two by sea. He didn't mention air because right now we're seeing a big-time performance, aren't we? That's two touchdowns so far in this game.
Where'd you pull that one from?
Hey, you know, every now and then I actually listened in history class.
And you're just a scholar all the way around. You're reading all the time. I like that you fit that in the broadcast.
You know, I just grab a nugget when I can.
Calais on the return. The Bucs take over first and 10. At their own 23-yard.
Mike Evans in the Tampa offense about to set up shop. The early returns for him, very good to start this season. Interesting to see if he can keep up that torrid pace.
Man, when you're talking about averaging 100 yards a game as a receiver. Extrapolate that over 16 games, and you're having a monster season. So, yeah, you love what he's doing early, but I think it's got to go back to the offseason, doesn't it? It's got to go back to the roots, spending time with the guy who's going to throw the ball to him, spending time watching tape, spending time reading defenses, and, of course, getting himself ready to play.
Here's a throw caught by Gronkowski, and he's taken down but able to slip across the 35. 15 yards on the play, first down. He's going to hit his man out of the backfield, complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. That's another gain of 15 on back-to-back plays. And nearly picked off. Surprising to see a defender his caliber let it get away, but it does get away and it's second down. Brady's incompletion on first down leads to a second and 10. Throwing again, Brady. Pass complete to his receiver, Godwin.
Pass complete to Chris Godwin. A 7-yard gain on the play.
Second down completion, got him 7. Now here's 3rd and 3. Now Brady again. He's got Evans. Oh, now he's strapped. He lost the football. And this is picked up by the Dolphins. And they have the football and will take over at the 24-yard line.
We have seen this before, and we know coaches preach about this and work on it all the time. Catch the ball. You know there's going to be some traffic somewhere. They've got to put it away and secure it as they try and get downfield.
This taken in by Jakeem Grant. And they nearly get this all the way to midfield. Mark him down at the 49. On first down, Tagovailoa. They'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. It's another first down as they bite off 23 more on that one. So in the second quarter, he's already up over 100 yards receiving now.
And isn't 100 the magic number for a really good game for a receiver? So he got a chance to really shatter that and have a profound effect on this game.
That's complete to his tight end, Mike Gesicki. And he will take it in for a Dolphins touchdown. Mike Gesicki with 2 touchdowns on the season, both in this game, as his guys continue to pour it on. And the route is on here in this first half. So a 75-yard scoring drive on just 3 plays. And it winds up in 6 points for the Dolphins. Now after the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Sanders.
The Bucs take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
Here we go again with Tom Brady in Tampa's offense. And how does he rally the troops, so to speak? He's played well, but they're down big on the scoreboard. How does he get his guys going?
To make sure they understand it's not a me game, it's a team game. Everyone has to come together. Everyone has to up the level of play a little bit, including himself, and find a way to make some plays in order to give them a little bit of a spark and rally the team.
We'll see if they can indeed rally down big on the scoreboard right now. Looking for Godwin, and he's got him complete. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40. 16 more on that one and another first down.
First down, Buccaneers.
On first down, Brady. And that is incomplete, stopping the clock with 5 seconds to go.
Austin Seibert on for the field goal. A 58-yard attempt.
And this won't get there. Won't be online either. It's no good. Off to the right. So we've reached halftime here in what is quickly turning into quite a rout. As we go up to Orlando now and hand it over to Jonathan Coachman with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Take it away, Coach.
Okay, Brandon, thanks very much. Time to give you folks at home a look around the NFL on this first official weekend of fall. So let's get to it. We'll get started over at Mercedes-Benz Stadium in downtown Atlanta. And that one finds the Falcons out in front. Todd Gurley, the lone touchdown there as he's cashed one in on the ground. From there, we're off to Tennessee to check on the Titans at home in Nashville. And at this point, they trail the visiting Baltimore Ravens. Lamar Jackson with 3 touchdown passes. Finally, let's get down to the Bayou. Check on the Saints at home at the Mercedes-Benz Superdome. And for the moment, they find themselves trailing the visiting Carolina Panthers. The Panthers trying to hold on and claim victory. Meanwhile, our game has been a boat race. Very one-sided to this point. And for the call of the second half, let's get it back to our commentating team of Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three.
Jason Sanders to kick off for Miami.
The first half, no contest. What will the second half bring as we are back and underway on EA Sports? And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line.
The Bucs take over first and 10. At their own 26.
Out come the Buccaneers. They'll have it first to start the third quarter. And they've got to be a little bit frustrated about that last drive. Missed field goal.
Always hurts a team because, you know, you put something out there. You've given yourself a chance. You're in range, and the ball doesn't go through the post. But it's not something to panic about, I don't believe. Just keep playing and keep going.
Well, they certainly have been able to get him going and establish the run, so I think it's time to abandon that plan and start chucking it all over the park. And you know who's excited about that? The defensive front. They got just pin their ears back and get after him now.
And he'll scratch out only about a yard up to the 32. They follow up the gain of five by only getting one there on second down.
And it's third down.
From the gun on third down, Brady. Open man is Howard, the tight end. And he is going to have a Bucs first down as he'll be marked down a yard or two past the marker following a gain of six. So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Working from the gun, it's Brady. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And this will be good for a pickup of nine to the 46.
It's a gain of nine.
That last catch short of the marker by just a yard leaves him with a very manageable second and one. Brady gives this one off to Jones. And he'll take it down shy of the 45 at the 46.
Jones, the ball carrier. The tackle.
But they've certainly been successful throwing it around in this game. That's allowed them to move the ball on offense. But I've got to tell you, to watch them run the football and successfully, I'm not taking sides. But to see the ball in a running back's hands, oh, that's football for me.
Devon Gotcho up to make the tackle.
A gain of a yard brings up second and nine.
On second and nine, Brady. Pressure here, and down he goes. Sacked back at about the 43-yard line. Christian Wilkins. What a play by him. That's going to go as a loss of 13. So Brady and the Bucs need to work a little magic. Third and long after that last sack. Operating from the gun. Brady quickly to Gronkowski. That's caught. And he'll be brought down at the 48-yard line. They do get 10 back, but still a ways to go on fourth.
Well, that's certainly playing down in distance very well by the defense, isn't it? Take whatever you want underneath, by all means.
The punt team on now as Pinion sends this one away. Here comes Grant on the return. A nice punt, but a good run back as well, 13 yards. And it'll be Dolphin football. So here are the Dolphins now. They get ready for their first possession of the second half. They are just putting things together so well here, drive after drive. They really have captured the momentum, haven't they?
They've taken momentum and pretty much not just give them a jersey, but a seat on the bench.
And he's into the clear. Past the 20.
Pass him in.
And all the way in for a Miami touchdown. Jakeem Grant, 82 yards. And this offense continues to pour it on.
Sanders for the extra point.
This offense, they were dynamic in the first half. The halftime break, that didn't slow down. A big strike here in the third quarter.
It's almost as if they were saying it's not just our skill in the first half is getting this done, it's confidence as well. And confidence has taken over this game in a big way. 11 working well together, but every now and then, partner, you need that one guy who can make a play against all odds that maybe can ignite things, and I think that's what they're looking for right now.
Yeah, you talk about going to your playmakers. They probably need to do it.
Find someone that you're used to touching the football that makes big plays and give them that opportunity to maybe wake up everyone else.
Here's a throw right side taken in by his tight end, and he'll be brought down right around the 37. 4 yards the pickup, first down.
First down, Buccaneers.
From the gun, Brady. And this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down.
Another attempt, another incompletion, and when I look at the scoreboard and where we are in this game, it comes to mind that they have to start getting the ball in the hands of their playmakers. Throw it to the guys that maybe can take a short pass and turn it into a long gain or make people miss downfield. They've got to have points, and the guys who can put the ball in the end zone, they're the ones that need to touch the ball. When Mike Evans sees man coverage, I don't think he's the only guy who gets excited. I'll guarantee the guy throwing the ball does, because guess what? He's got a lot of options about where to place it because of Mike Evans' size and frame.
Now a first down carry by Jones. And not able to break away this time as they're going to stop him right around the line of scrimmage. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
This defense is just flat getting after it. They have not given up much of anything in the run game. Case in point right there.
Second and 12, Brady, incomplete, Brady. And just not enough on the throw there, down around his feet and incomplete, an incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down, operating from the gun, Brady, and this is going to be incomplete.
Sometimes it's just not your day. There's another failure right there on third down.
Here's Bradley Pinion now, as he'll punt it away for the fourth time today. They'll score that a 36-yard punt, and the Dolphins' drive will start deep in their own territory with a first and 10. The field position game, such an overlooked facet, Charles, of an NFL game, but this offense, they're going to be pinned back. What an ideal punt.
An ideal punt, and it leads to that term complementary football, because them doing that puts their defense in a great spot, doesn't it? Gives them a chance. If they want to be aggressive, try and maybe get a safety out of this whole thing, it puts them in that position.
23 yards on the pickup there, and a first. Found a little room there as he's up to about the 37.
White on the tackle.
5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here, because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football. Sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work. And there we saw one of the downsides of blitzing during a rundown, because sometimes you get out of your gaps. You don't fit the run quite as well because you're headed towards the ball carrier with abandon.
Give him 12 yards there, and the Dolphins have a first down. So first and 10, and if they score on this drive, might have to start digging in our second half blowout material. Now the former fourth-round pick, it's Kalen Ballage. And he's got room. And he'll head out of bounds inside the 10, mark him down at the 9. A big play on the ground there, and goes for 36 yards. The chain gang hustling to catch up. Here's first and goal from just inside the 10, Ballage. And the Dolphins are going to be set up with a first and goal. He couldn't quite reach the chalk, but they'll have it at the 1 yard line. It'll be a pickup of 8 and a good first. And he will take it in for a Dolphins touchdown. Kalen Ballage, his second touchdown on the season. And the Dolphins have got it on cruise control. And he was excellent on that drive. He deserved to be the one to get across the chalk.
Oh, I agree with you totally. A workhorse on the drive. And how about that last decisive run to punch it in?
Jason Sanders to kick off for Miami.
Now after the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Sanders. Now this will make it into the end zone. And he'll just take a seat, and the drive will begin at the 25-yard line.
25-yard line.
Here comes the Tampa Bay offense now heading back out onto the field. He's possession, and that's become too familiar of a refrain. Too many of these drives just wound up going nowhere.
But you know how in baseball, when the pitcher gets a base hit and he's on base, they bring his jacket out to him to keep him warm? A lot of times the punter goes to the sideline, puts on sweatpants or a wrap over his leg to keep it warm. He might need a massage from the trainer right now from all the work he's getting.
They'll operate from the 32-yard line here, second and three. Again, it's Jones. 4 yards the pickup, first down.
Well, they're hoping that the second half is better for him than the first half. They've got to find a way to get him going. He's a big part of their offense.
On the play. First down, Tampa Bay.
They'll run on first down. It's Jones, and he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
A loss of two brings up second and 12.
Second and 12. And that is going to do it for this third quarter of action. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. On second and 12, Brady. He gets it into the hands of Gronkowski. Complete. That throw good for only a couple. It brings up third down. One thing I think that's safe to say defensively, the tackling's been really good.
And because of that, it's been very, very hard for them to move the ball because you're not getting the benefits of run after catch. You tackle them almost on the spot. That means you have to run extra plays, harder to move it.
And he is going to have the Buccaneers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. It's a gain of 16, first down Tampa Bay. Shotgun now for Brady. And that going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down. Brady's incompletion on first down leads to a second and 10. To throw again. Brady. He's got his big tight end, Gronkowski. He'll get only three there, so it leaves him with a third and 7 ahead.
Well, they're unable to convert that into much, but it's never a bad idea to try to get the ball into a tight end of his caliber's hands and see what kind of disruption he can cause.
They'll need to get this to the 38. That's where the first down marker is here on third. Again, they'll throw with Brady. And that is incomplete. Well, the trials and tribulations of being a quarterback in this league, it's tough. It's got to be wearing on him out there.
Well, he has been sacked a number of times. He had an interception, so I'm going to give him a skosh of credit for hanging in there and trying to make something happen, despite the amount of pressure he's been under this entire game.
And he deserves a bronze leg as he gets this one away. And no return here. Where will they spot it? They say just outside the 20-yard line. So now the Dolphins set to take over on offense. They've won two straight, and they lead this one as well as they come up on first and 10. Here's a pass swung out left to his running back. And he's taken down but able to slip across the 35. That play going for 16 yards to start the drive. First down. Out of the shotgun, Breida. And some room to work. And he's going to be taken down here with a penalty flag on the field. That's a good chunk of yardage. It's going to be canceled out.
And we always talk about hidden yardage in a game. That's going to count as that because now it doesn't go on the books, but now they have to make that up again, don't they?
This is Breida. They get 1 yard back there to make it second and 14. And now they're in the hurry up. They run again with Breida. They're going to snuff this play out behind the line. We have not seen that much today. They lose two on that last play, so things get even tougher. Third and long coming up.
Brandon, it's clearly a running situation when you're up in the fourth quarter. They're going to have to stack the box and make it difficult for them to move the ball.
Made it very difficult right there, and now they need to repeat that effort.
Yeah, bring 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take to slow them down.
And with things looking pretty good on the scoreboard, they're going to keep the offense out there and go for it here on fourth. Now they go for it on fourth, but this one is going to wind up incomplete. Boy, it looked like he had it and dropped it. And the Bucs are going to take over with excellent. position to boot. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. Brady going to throw. And now a fumble. Brady loses the football. And this is picked up by the Dolphins. And his guys are going to take over at the 39-yard line. So they keep the ball, but work to do on second and long. Now after the fumble recovery, it's Brady. That's complete to his running back, Evans. And he's got this down almost to the 20 before he's dropped. It's a pickup of 17 and a first down.
First down, Buccaneers.
On the delay, Jones. And he'll take this inside the 20 and down to the 18. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8.
A gain of 2 brings up second and 8.
They'll go again to Jones. And he'll get this one down to about the 17. Only a yard of the pickup there, and it'll bring up a third down.
It's a gain of a yard. And it's third down.
From the gun, Brady. It's a slant to Gronkowski. And he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Buccaneers.
Gronkowski.
From 17 yards out. And the Bucs are able to get a score back.
On that third down call, the goal was to get the ball to their tight end and pick up a first down, but he wasn't satisfied with just that. They got the first down. That was the gravy. He decided to take in the whole meal and rumbled in for a touchdown.
Here's Seibert now to add the extra point. And they make the score a little bit more respectable here in our final quarter of play. So that drive, 4 plays, and it ends with a touchdown for the Bucs. Now Pinion with the kickoff honors following the touchdown. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully.
Made at the 25-yard line.
Matt Breed in the offense heading back out. He's been a good workhorse. I know we use the word workhorse a lot, but he's been a good workhorse for him in this one.
No doubt about it, and there's nothing wrong with that. That's what you're looking for if you're a back, because that means everything's come together for you. Big guys up front have created space. You've run through it, and you've probably got some help even from the wide receivers who want to catch passes as opposed to block. But they're helping out, too.
Yeah, everyone's pitching in. He's had a good game. They stay on the ground. Again, it's Breida. They'll get 3 as the drive continues. It's a first down. And they're going to speed things up here.
Miami Dolphins.
2 and now on first down. Looking left side, and he's got a man. It's Grant. 7 yards, the pickup there.
It's a gain of 7. Brings up 2nd and 3.
On 2nd down, a run with Breida. And he'll be taken down at the 46-yard line. They'll get 3 as the drive continues. It's a first down. Here's Breida. He finds some open field here. And they're able to work this to the 25 before it's all said and done. A big run there. 29 yards and a first. Tua going to hand this one to Breida. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. 2 yards the loss, 2nd and 12.
Brings up 2nd.
They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And he tried to bounce it outside, but they'll stop it behind the line. That'll wind up as a loss on the play, so now they're staring at a 3rd down and 12. On the handoff, this is Breida. And he'll get this to the 23, but that'll be well short of what he needed. It'll be a gain of 4, but it won't be enough. It leaves him with a 4th down now.
And he continues to pile up the yardage. That puts him over a buck 50 now. And this defense has really had its problems trying to keep him contained.
And they're going to try the screen. It's complete. And now this is going to depend on the spot. And they say he's just short. welcome you back. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. From the gun, it's Brady. Throw right side, taken in by Godwin. And he's taken down, but not before he gets this across the 25-yard line. Nice way to start the drive, a gain of 12 and a first down. Operating from the gun, Brady, quick hitter here, it's complete. And this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down.
Brings up second and one.
And looking to throw again on second down. Brady, over the middle, he finds Godwin, complete.
Good throw, good catch, but I really like the route. The drag and being able to run away from defenders, hard to stick with them for that long.
Yeah, better against man than zone, or?
Better against man, because now you're running away from someone, and you're not running into a defensive player in another zone.
I think that was good strategy there, trying to go right back to him after the last completion, but this time, the defense was all over him, and they got there to break that one up.
Looking back to the air on second down, it's Brady. And the Dolphins rush gets home. Down he goes. Kyle Van Noy leading the surge there as he drops him for a loss of 6. On third and long, it's Brady. And the throw there going to be incomplete.
This has been a rough one, to put it mildly, for him. But after this one's done, you just feel like at the post-game press conference, this team's going to have a lot of questions and definitely not a lot of answers.
And on fourth down, on is the punt team sending this one. And he can't field it cleanly. It's loose. But fortunately, he's able to recover his own fumble, or that could have been trouble.
At their own 15-yard line.
The Dolphins at the line, ready for their next drive. And this game comfortably in hand. The scoreboard speaks for itself, but you still got your starting quarterback out there. When do you go to the backup? Let him get some time.
And that's one of the great questions in the NFL, Brandon, because I'm just going to tell you, in the 2015 season, I commentated on 3 games in a row that were blowouts. And in none of them did the starting quarterback ever come out of the game for the team that had a big lead. And in each instance, I asked the coaches later on, why didn't you do that? And they all looked at me and said, just don't really do that in the NFL. We, you know, these guys play, and we just play them all the way through. Now, in certain situations, they will take them out, but for the most part, they're not as worried and concerned about getting them out of the game, and that's always puzzled me a little bit.
Well, Charles, it's one thing to win. It's another thing to win and put up the amount of points that they did. Why were they clicking on offense?
They can't help but feel great about themselves, can they? I mean, what a game to put up that number of points, continually feel like they're moving the ball and things are working and clicking. They think that they can bottle this and carry it with them.
And as an offensive coordinator, you just don't think you can do anything wrong. Whatever you call, run, pass, it's all going to work.
That's called being in the zone.
So for the Dolphins, it's an ideal start as they move to 3-0 now on the young season. And they'll be able to enjoy this one through the bye week before they get back at it again. Meanwhile, for Tampa Bay, the early struggles continue as they'll sink to 0-3. And they'll try to make amends next week as they host the New Orleans Saints. So for Charles Davis and our entire crew, I'm Brandon Gaudin. Next game, guess what? Charles and I will be here again. It's the NFL on EA Sports.